Illinois.
Last few years have actually brought us to the point where we've gone from essentially last in the Big Ten in terms of BTU per square foot to absolutely the best in the Big Ten. Everybody is looking for how do you now integrate demand and purchase or production. We actually have the ability to purchase or produce to a greater degree than most of them, the way they're constructed. If we can lead the way here, we've got all of our peers want to come and figure it out too.
Look at everything all together on the energy and utility. It's about $100 million a year business here at the university.
We've been very successful in our energy conservation efforts at Illinois. We've been utilizing retrocommissioning, energy performance contracting, doing lighting retrofits, coupled with DCEO grants, and have been able to reduce our energy consumption in our buildings by 28% since 2008.
Room we're sitting in now is the start of what we're calling the Energy Management Control Center. And that will bring all the different data systems into one area where we can be more fully integrated in how we're doing operations.
We have some ability to do demand response. We can shift about 8 megawatts of power from the daytime to the nighttime with our thermal storage system, which is very helpful. But we can take asset optimization further with all of our production facilities and do more on demand response once we get this all up and working the way that we envision. There are a lot of advantages in integrating the new technologies, but there's also a lot of risk in being able to keep those newer, higher technical systems operating the way they should. So that's part of what this room will be, for us to be more proactive in trying to keep these systems that need a little bit more oversight up and running the way they should.
Since I've been here, the amount of controls have doubled. It went from really getting complaints about temperatures not cold, you know, I'm too hot or too cold, to us being able to tackle the problem before the end user or in the space actually even knows there's a problem.
When we're able to forecast our loads and be able to see how the market's reacting to the things happening that day, we can make decisions on asset allocation in order to make us more cost effective. Currently, we're doing a master plan for our production and distribution. We realize that Illinois is a leader and very proactive right now in our energy management. And we want to continue trying to be at the forefront of new integration of systems and new technologies to more fully develop different opportunities and share that information with others as we find things to work.
We're now at the point where we're ready to see what's next. Well, what's next is to be able to integrate all of this. I believe there's no doubt that the future is building systems that allow the owner to balance increasing power requirements with a need to contain operating costs. The investments we've made here at Illinois to reduce energy demand and carbon emissions, while at the same time increasing the efficiency of our production units, has brought us to the point where we are ready to focus on building systems integration. The development of our Energy Management Control Center and continued investments in systems and controls will allow us to manage our demand in a way that optimizes our production and our purchase decisions, while at the same time allowing us to minimize costs for the University of Illinois.